you feel it. Hallelujah. The Spirit of the Lord is in this place. Praise God. Somebody commented to me a minute ago, said, you may not know it, but you got the greatest praise team in any church of God in this area. Praise God.
Come on.
I believe it. Praise God. Praise team. God. Glory to God. They lift up God, and we lift up God with them, don't we? Thank God. Thank God. Sunday after resurrection celebration. Amen. You know, after the first church realized what really had happened, see, they made a lot of boo-boos. They denied God even, and all that during the crucifixion of Christ. But after the resurrection, man, things begin to change. So I'm looking for things to begin to change in the Tri-Cities Church of God, because we're living in the resurrected Christ. We're living in the Jesus that said, all power is given unto me. Heaven and earth, praise God. Greater things than you do. Oh, glory to God. He also told us, and I want to tell you this, he said, ye shall seek me. He said, if any man thirst, it's in John chapter 7, 37, if any man thirst, if you're thirsty for God, then let him come unto me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly, who's belly? The believer's belly. Out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water, praise God. He says, but this spake he of the Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive. Praise God. Amen. If you haven't received the baptism of the Holy Spirit, just ask him. It's his good pleasure to give his children the gifts of God. Praise God. We want to ask you to pray a special prayer for Brother Bill Preston. Sister Carrie sent us a text this morning about 6 o'clock that they had to take Dad to the ER. And I found out, I came into church over here on this side, that my wife had received another text that have found out that he does have pneumonia. He has pneumonia in both lungs. So we know that's very serious. Let's pray for Brother Bill Preston. Would you do that? Let's pray right now. In the holy name of Jesus, God, we lift up our Brother Bill. God, we know that you're able to touch his body. We know that he's been going through trials and troubles. His health hasn't been as good as he would like to for it to be. God, we just pray that you'll touch him. Give him some good days now, Father. Give him some good days. Raise him back up. I know he'll give you glory. I know he'll praise you for it. God, I just ask it in Jesus' name. God, you're a good, good God. You're a heavenly Father. And you know what he means, God. We ask you to take him in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. And if you have a name, would you lift your hand? God knows. God knows you. God knows your heart. And he knows what you need. Father, we pray for every man, woman, boy, girl. God, whatever need they will have today, whether it be healing, whether it be encouragement, whether it be faith, whatever it would be, God, spiritually, physically, financially, God, you're a father who knows how to take care of your sons and your daughters, and we give you glory and praise for it. Amen, amen. Praise God. Let's continue to praise the Lord. Let's praise the team. Take us back some more. If you have an offering to give, you can do that at this time. Thank you for being faithful. Praise God. Glory to God.
Oh, I'm gonna see you.
Amen. We got some super spreaders in here. Super spreaders of the Holy Ghost. Come on. You can't tell it how good it is, but you can feel it. You can feel it, yes. Praise God, praise God. Amen, we love you guys. Anybody got a hallelujah down in our ears, God? Praise God. I believe you want to hear the shofar. Did you bring it to me? Amen. Get that thing out of its case, sir. Blow the dust out of it, man. Ain't no dust in it, but praise God. It keeps that blood out over his neighborhood. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's praise God. He's gonna come, the sound of the trumpet. The dead in Christ are gonna rise. Oh, we need a light in the name to go in the chain. Come on, in the twinkle of an eye. Whoa, praise God. Woo! My Jesus. God. Oh, praise God. Sing it, thank you, sing it, Lord. Praise God. We're going to ask a good preacher here in a minute. Mr. Leslie's going to sing for us. Jason's going to preach. Thank God. Let's worship God. Thank you. Sister Leslie's coming to minister a song just before Jason comes to preach. Look over at your neighbor and say, man, you look good today. You look good. The Bible says God beautifies the meek with salvation. Praise God. If you're saved, you're beautiful. Amen. God bless you.
switch many times if I'm full with it. Of course, every day's a new day with me. Dad used to work with Dad all the time, and that's one thing he'd bust at me and say, "My Lord Jason, today's not a new day. What we did yesterday, it's just the same. It hasn't changed since you slept last night, but it did for me, because once I slept, I forgot, amen, about what I did the day before." Praise God. So good to see you here today. Amen. Such a beautiful group of people. God's blessed us. God's touched us. God's helping us. Would you just stand to your feet and let's just take just a moment. I want to just encourage you. Amen. Dad's been trying to encourage us as a church and as a body of believers. I want you to know that worship and praise is a weapon. It's a weapon that you have that the devil tries his best to hinder it, tries his best to stop it, tries his best to make you think, well, that's crazy, that's foolishness. There's no need to do that. But I'm telling you, there's something powerful that takes place in your heart and in your life when you clap your hands, when you raise your hands, when you lift your voice unto the Lord and you cry out, praise God, just like that shofar cried out. Your voice can become a shofar, amen. And you, the Bible says that if we let God arise, amen, that His enemies will be scattered, praise God. When we allow God to arise, guess what happens? The enemy begins to run. The enemy begins to run. And I don't know how many of you, if the enemy's bombarding your life, or if he's trying to attack, or he's trying to bother and mess with you this week. Amen. I believe without a shadow of a doubt, I know that some of us, or all of us, if you're not under attack this week, you will be next week. It's coming your way. But I'm telling you, if you'll worship and praise God right in the middle of your mess, amen, there's something that powerful happens in worship. Praise God. I want you just to lift your hands before God and praise Him for that promise, that song that she sung about. You have a promise from God, amen, that God said, "I will never leave you. I will never forsake you." He's going to be with you all the way to the end of this thing. He that had begun work in you is able to bring it to completion. He will not fail you. He will not let you down. He will never, never, never leave you or forsake you. Praise God. I don't know about anybody else, but that's good news to know. That's good news to know. We could just shut up and sit down out there at that point and we all could be happy and say we've heard a good message today. And Jesus will never leave us. He'll never forsake us. Praise God. Remain standing with me. If you have your Bibles, look with me in Luke chapter 10:19. We read to you out of the New King James Version. Luke 10:19, very familiar verse of Scripture we've read. I want you to know something. We're living not just because of last week, what we celebrated last week. We actually celebrate that every Sunday. We celebrate the resurrection every Sunday. But because of the resurrection, because of what happened on Friday on the cross of Calvary, and then because of all that took place, you're standing today, regardless of what you're at, where you're at, what you're going through, you're standing on the side of victory. You're standing on victory's side. You're standing on the winning side. Amen. Isn't it always good to be on the winning side? Amen. We've played a lot of ball this weekend and we've had some great, we've been on the losing side. And when we were on the losing side, I mean, we were on the losing side. And it wasn't just like close. Some of them were close, but the majority of them that we did lose, it was a big loss. And it was just like, this is going to take a miracle, you know, to bring us out of this one, which miracles happen and they do sometimes. But It's not fun to be on the losing side. But when you're on the winning side, it's always fun. And then even if you feel sorry for the other team a little bit, that's still fun. You know, you just like bless her little heart. Sure, I know it feels bad to be where they're at, but it always just feels better to be on the winning side. But that's the way we are in the kingdom of God. I want you to know you're always on the side of victory. You're always on the winning side. Don't ever let the enemy think you're on the losing side. You're always on the winning side. Luke 10:19 said, "Behold, I give you." This is written in red. This is Jesus speaking to us. I mean, how many likes it when Jesus talks to us? And it's written in red, said, "Behold, I give you the authority to trample on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you." Praise God. Say nothing. Amen. Nothing shall by any means hurt you. Man, now go to the Luke 24. This is after Jesus had risen from the dead and he had shown himself to his disciples and he was getting ready to leave. And in verse 49 of chapter 24 says, "Behold, I send the promise of the Father upon you. But tarry in the city of Jerusalem until you are endued with power." Say power.
Power.
How many believe we've been endued and we've been given authority and power? Praise God. You've been endued with power from on high. And he led them out as far as Bethany, and he lifted up his hands and bless them. Praise God. Hallelujah. Turn to your neighbor and say, "You're blessed."
Blessed.
Yeah. Hallelujah. You are blessed. And now it came to pass while he blessed them that he was parted from them and carried up into heaven. And they worshiped him and returned to Jerusalem with great what? Joy. My Bible says joy. You're saying power. Amen. Great joy. Power's good too. I like power. And we're continually in the temple praising and blessing God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Today, after you stand with me and I want you to stretch your hand and pray, I've been writing prayers and whether you agree with it or not, whatever you think, I want to just share this prayer that I wrote. I think it's important that we pray what the Word of God says. Confession, Jesus, the Word of God tells us that we're to hold fast to our confession. Confession is this. Confession is agreeing with what God says. Some of us in the charismatic Pentecostal movement have been made fun of and laughed at or said, "Oh, that's just the old name and claim it crowd. They just blab it and grab it. They just say it, confess it." But listen, confession is not just saying something out in the blue to happen. Confession is simply this: I agree with what God says. And I say what God says. And when you say what God says and you agree with what God says, there's power in that. There's power. Things will come to pass into your life when we agree with what God says. So stretch your hand this way, and I want to read this prayer. "The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it, and they are saved. Today we declare that no weapon formed against us will prosper. Every word that arises against us, the Lord will condemn it. This is our heritage, and our righteousness is of Him." Praise God. "David said to the enemy, 'You come to me with spear and sword, but I come to you in the name of the Lord.' The Word of God teaches us that the weapons that we have are not carnal. They're not natural, but they're mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds and casting down imaginations. We lift up the name of Jesus over fear and anxiety. For God, you have not given us the spirit of fear, but you've given us a spirit of power
love, and a sound mind. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
You said in your word to call out to you and you will answer. You said if we would humble ourselves and pray, repent of our wickedness, that you would hear us and save us. We trust in you today. We lean not to our own understanding. In all of our ways, we acknowledge you. And you said you will direct and guide us. Now we thank you, Lord, that you are protecting us. No sickness or disease will come near us, according to Psalms 91 and 10. For you are a shield around us. And it may look like we're surrounded today by the enemy, outmatched and overwhelmed. But praise God, but we are surrounded today by your army angels, sent forth to minister to those who are the heirs of salvation. Our eyes are upon you today, and we hear you speaking to us, saying, stand still. Be still. Hallelujah. Be still and know that I am God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. And amen. Father, speak to us today. Touch us today. Let us know that God, without a shadow of a doubt, God, that we're on the side of victory today. And you are for us and you're not against us. In Jesus' wonderful name. Amen. And amen. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. You can be seated. I hope you don't stay seated all day today. Praise God. I hope you stand up and shout. Amen. Like a team on the winning side. Praise God. Amen. Your team's running and scoring a touchdown. You see people, whatever team you're on, if that's your team, they'll stand up, they'll clap, and they'll say go. Praise God. So I want you to cheer me on today. Will you help me out a little bit today? Praise God. The outcome of your life is ultimately influenced by what begins in your mind, by what you believe. A single thought can have a viral effect and take over other aspects of your life, ultimately transforming who you are, for better or for worse. Real transformation happens when we quit believing the lies of the enemy and renew our mind with the truth of His Word. Romans 12:2 says, and do not, say not, do not. That's pretty clear. Pretty clear. It's not like, well, maybe, no, it says, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Today I continue to confess what the Word of God says. I'm not fearful. I'm not timid. But I have power, love, and a sound mind. I am chosen, accepted, and adopted into God's family. I have the Holy Spirit, so I'm not a slave to fear. Activate the Word. I am more than a conqueror. I don't fight for victory, but I stand in the victory of Jesus. His finished work on the cross assures me of forgiveness, healing, peace, provision, protection, and acceptance of God. No attack, threats, lies, or accusations can steal these away from me. Not now, in the future. I declare that today in the name of Jesus. Praise God. My message today, the title of my message is Keys. Anybody say keys?
Keys.
Man, you got keys in your hand or something? Jingle for me just a little bit. Anybody got any keys to jingle in here? Yeah, I want to hear some keys.
Yeah.
Keys, what do keys do? They open stuff. They turn on stuff. They give us access to stuff. They give us the ability, amen, to get in our car and start it and get moving in the direction that we need to go. Keys are very important in our life. Keys are things that we need very, very much to get about and to do what we need to do throughout the day. Keys are important. And these keys, amen, I want to talk to you, keys to defeating the enemy's lies about the truth. You believe the enemy wants to lie to you? Is the enemy being lying to any of you today? Or this week? He's a liar. I heard a preacher just this week said a lady came up for prayer And she, as he was, he asked her, he said, "Hey, how can I pray for you?" And she said, "The enemy's just lying to me." And he said, "So you know it's in?" "Yeah, it's in. He's lying." "And he know he's lying?" "Yeah, he's lying." He said, "Well, what do you want me to have you do to pray?" Only thing I can tell you, just quit believing the lies. Stop believing the lies. Somebody's lying to you, stop believing the lies. If the enemy's lying to you, how do you know when he's lying to you? You get in the Word of God and you see what God says about you and see what God says is for you and what the life that he has. He said, the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus said, "I have come that you might have life and have it to the full and then have it more abundantly." He wants to give you life. In the very beginning, in the book of Genesis, we see how the enemy began to lie. Amen. To Adam and Eve. The Bible says in Genesis 1:28, "And God blessed them. And God said to them, be fruitful and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves on the earth." God had given his creation dominion. He had given them authority. He'd given them, amen, the ability. He said it there that whatever Adam calls it, that's what it'll be. Dan and I were just talking the other day how intelligent of a man Adam must have been to be able to take all of the creation, all that God had created, all the animals, all the things that had been created by God. And Adam was smart enough and intelligent enough to give it a name. And the Bible says that that God had given him that authority, had given him that ability and that dominion to whatever he called it, that's what it was. And dominion and authority had been given to them in the garden. It belonged to God's creation. But Adam and Eve, you know the story. The serpent came and began to tempt Eve, began to say a little bit about what the Word of God said. God had said plainly to them, "If you eat of this one tree, you will surely die." The enemy came to him and said, "Hath God said you would really die? Is that really what he said?" He just wanted to cast the seeds of doubt, just like he does in all of our lives today. God says plainly in his Word that by his stripes we were healed. He was wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. Praise God. He's a healer. He has paid the price for our healing. He's paid the price for our deliverance. He's paid the price to bring salvation to our hearts and lives. But the enemy wants to say to you, "Did God really say that? Then why do you feel the way you feel? Why are you going through what you're going through? Why is things happening in your life right now, if that's the case? Why is your mind a mess? Why are you filled with anxiety? Why are you filled with no peace whatsoever?" The enemy's lying to you. And then quit believing the lie. Stand up and realize that God has given us authority and power. But this authority was handed over. Amen. Say, handed it over. Man, they handed it over to him. Adam and Eve handed over the authority through disobedience. In Luke chapter 4, verse 6, when Jesus was being tempted in the wilderness, the devil came to him and said to him, he said, "All this authority I will give you, and their glory, for this has been delivered to me." This is the devil talking. He said, "This authority has been delivered to me." Who was it delivered to him from? Adam and Eve. "And I will give it to whoever I wish." The enemy wants to convince you today that he still has it. How many knows that's not true? How many believes that's a lie? How many understand that that's a lie? He doesn't have authority. Amen. In Genesis chapter 3, verse 15, we realize that God, like he always does, when the enemy has a plan to take you out, God always has a plan to keep you in. God's always got a plan. Amen. The Bible said before the foundations of the world were framed, amen, the Lamb of God was slain before the foundation of the world. Amen. Before all of this went away, before all of it went sideways, none of it got God by surprise. Praise God. God had a plan. God had a plan. Praise God. God provided for his people. says, I will put enmity between you and the woman, between you, between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel. But that word bruise there is more than just you get a bruise when somebody punches you in the arm. Amen. But that word bruise there should have been translated a little different. Amen. Because if you look it up and study it out, that the word bruise there means to overwhelm, to break, and to totally destroy. Hallelujah. How many knows the enemy's been totally destroyed? The Bible tells us in 1 John, I think 3:8, says this is the reason the Son of Man was manifest. Jesus came to this earth. Why? That he may destroy the works of the devil. Praise God. How many believes on Easter morning when he got up out of that grave? Hallelujah. The Bible says that he went down into the bowels of the earth. He went down into hell itself. And there he set captive. He led captivity captive. He led them out. Praise God. He came down preaching. Amen. The Son of God has paid the price. All those that were in that holding place there, he came preaching Jesus to them. He let them say that, I am that one. I am the Son of God. He led them out. Amen. Of captivity. He led them out of there. He grabbed, amen, the devil by the nape of the neck. And he said, give me the keys. Amen. Those keys belong to me. You no longer have authority. What once was handed over to you, you've got to hand it back, because the Son God. And all authority. And he said, this authority that I have, Jesus said, I have given it unto you. I've given you authority. Stand up and be the church of God has called you to be. Colossians 2:14, verse 15 says, having wiped out the handwriting of requirements that was against us, which was contrary to us. And he has taken it out of the way, having nailed it to the cross, having disarmed principalities and powers. Praise God. Hallelujah. He stripped them. Amen. He stripped them. Amen. He took it. He disarmed them. Praise God. Just reached over and unbuckled the belt and jerked it open, and the gun fell and hit the ground. The handcuffs fell and hit the ground. They were stripped of their authority. Praise God. Hallelujah. No more. Praise God. Authority. Even in the dead, in the darkness, and the devil has no authority. Amen. To hover over you. Don't you let him lie to you and act like he does. Amen. This is irrevocable. Amen. I said one Wednesday night, I was talking about the Bible says that in the same way, 1 Corinthians 11:25, this is amplified version, says in the same way, Jesus, after supper, he took the cup, saying this is the cup, the new covenant, ratified and established in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it, in affectionate remembrance of me. Amen. It's been ratified in his blood. The old covenant was not perfect. The old covenant was a type. The old covenant was a shadow. Many animals were sacrificed. The blood of goats and lambs and all those things in the old covenant had to take place, and it provided atonement. Atonement is not a New Testament word. Atonement is an Old Testament word. Amen. Atonement means to cover. Atonement means to just to satisfy for a little while. It's just a covering, praise God. But the New Testament, Jesus is saying, amen, when he came to fulfill everything in the Old Testament. He came to bring it into fulfillment. Amen. He entered in once, the Bible said. And he suffered and he bled and he died. And now the New Testament word that we've used to take the place of atonement is remission. Amen. Your sins have been remitted. Amen. Your sins have been washed. Your sins have been put away. Praise God. Your sins have been pardoned. Your sins have been taken away, cast as far as the east is from the west, thrown into the depths of the sea, never to be remembered anymore. Praise God. I like remission. I like the word remission. I like to know that my sins are gone. You ask me why I'm happy. I'll just tell you why. Because my sins are gone. Praise God, they are under the blood of the cross of Calvary. Dark from darkness to dawn. Praise God, never to be remembered again. John chapter 12, 30 and 32. Talking about just having an understanding and grasping the truth. Amen. That judgment came on the enemy. When Jesus came, He came to fix it. He came to get back what we had lost in the garden. Jesus came, and in the same garden of Gethsemane, praise God, in that garden, as He prayed till great drops of blood began to fall out of His brow, man, He suffered and He prayed there. If there's any way, God, that this could let this cup pass from me. He said, nevertheless, not my will, but Your will be done. And when He had committed to the cause, He committed to, praise God, that old man, Jesus. He was 100% man and 100% God. And that 100% man was the one crying out in the garden because He knew what was going to happen. He knew what was going to take place. But praise God, something of the Spirit of God entered Him. He said, nevertheless, not my will, but Your will be done. Hallelujah, I will go through with what I have to go through. And for the joy that's set before Him, the Bible says, He endured the cross. He despised the shame. He went forth and paid the price for you and for me. And then defeated the enemy. Jesus answered and said, this voice did not come because of me. Amen. If you read back just a few verses, He was there speaking, and a great thunder came out of the cloud. A voice came and spoke. Most people said, that sounds like thunder. But Jesus said, this sound that you hear, it's not because of me, but for your sake. Now is the judgment of this world. Now the ruler of this world will be cast out. And if I am lifted up from the earth, I will draw all peoples. I'll draw all men unto myself. Jesus was saying, I'm coming, praise God, to fix it. I'm coming to be that propitiation. I'm coming to be that substitute. I'm coming to be that virgin-born, sinless Savior that's going to save you from your sins. Praise God. The one that was prophesied from old 42 generations all the way through. Praise God. The seed of David. Jesus would defeat Satan by atoning for all sin. Sin is the legal means by which Satan keeps men in captivity. That means being removed, which it was by Christ. He leaves the evil one with no legal right unless men freely give him that right. Acceptance of Christ and the cross defeats Satan and breaks his bondage. Praise God. Amen. That's how you're saved. That's how you're set free. Amen. When you believe, the Bible says, if you believe upon the Lord Jesus Christ, you believe in your heart and confess with your mouth that God raised Jesus from the dead, the Bible says you shall be saved. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm glad I believe real quick. I'm glad I know the blessing that Jesus brings. Praise God. Victory is yours. Healing is yours. Peace is yours. Life is yours. Blessing is yours. Somebody say amen. And blessing is yours. Freedom is yours. Freedom from sin. Freedom from addiction. Freedom from your past. It all belongs to you because of the cross of Calvary. Not with the blood of goats and calves, but with His own blood. He entered in the most holy place once and for all, having obtained eternal, praise God, say eternal. Hallelujah. Eternal redemption. For Romans 6:14 says, for sin shall not have dominion over you. For you are not under the law, but under grace. Hallelujah. We're living far beneath our inheritance. Health and healing. Poverty. Freedom from fear. Power to occupy. Jesus told His people, occupy until I come. Continue to do business. Continue to go about preaching the word. Know that I'm with you. Lay hands on the sick. Cast out devils. Praise God. Go forth in my word and in my power. Do the works of God. Praise the Lord. That's what he wants us to do. Be overcomers. More than conquerors. Blessed, chosen, and beloved. Adopted. Amen. Redeemed. Seated with Christ. All of heaven is backing us. Authorized. That's who we are. Praise God. We just need to walk in it. Praise God. We just need to step in it. We've got to believe it in our hearts and begin to act it out with our lives. And God will back it up. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Will you stand with me? Praise God. I'm 2 pages in, but got 3 letters. I can't finish this right now. And Suzanne's here, she'll flog me when I get home. If I preach as long as I probably could this morning. Yes. Amen. Please do. You come back tonight, I'll finish it. Yeah, I will see everybody here this morning. Come on back tonight, we'll finish this message. The musicians will come. The rest of this message, that was a setup in the first part of it all. The rest of it is 3 points that I want to bring out to you of how that we can activate this. How do we activate this in our lives? How do we activate it? I'll just give you the points without going into any details, okay? God must be first in my life. That's how you activate it. God must be first in my life. Second thing is, understand that faith is the key that opens the door for every promise God has given us. Faith is the key. You say, what is that? What do you mean by that? You say, faith. What did it take for you to be saved? It takes faith to be saved. Those who come to God must believe that He is. He's a rewarder of them that diligently seek Him. Romans 10, 9 and 10 says, if you believe in your heart, confess with your mouth, Lord Jesus, you will be saved. That's what it says. That's the word of God. That's how faith works. You believe in your heart and you say with your mouth. That's the way we do with healing. That's the way we do with anything that's going on in our lives that shouldn't be. We find out in the word of God what God says about it. We believe it in our heart. We take the seed of the word and put it in our heart. Then we confess it with our mouth. And then a miracle. We hold fast to that profession. We don't turn it loose. Don't ever turn it loose. Keep believing what God said. Faith is the key that opens the door to every promise. Praise. Praise is the key that opens the door to the presence of God. And finally, there's only one way in. There's only one way in. That's through Jesus. Jesus is the only way in. He's the only way in. And He's awesome. He's the best thing that's ever happened to me. Jesus is the best thing that's ever happened to me in my life. You know He's the best thing that's ever happened. And as I begin to sing, these altars are open. Pray, come to pray. You will stay right there where you are. Lift your hand. Talk to your Creator. Talk to your God that loves you and cares about you. You can do that. But this verse, I'm telling you, there's power in praise. There's power in worship. Worship God. Thank you. healing. Was for our healing. And by His stripes we are healed. The enemy says that's a lie. He tells you that that's not true. It don't mean you. Don't believe the lie. It's important what you believe. Believe what God says. Hold on to the truth of the Word of God. Father, we pray.
Right now, God, that your angel walks.